Hey guys, welcome to another edition of Pike and Walleye Hunters here. I think I'm going to be heading out to Crawlin Valley today. I'm going to be working off the kind of the half part of the reservoir there, just off the boat launch. Going to be targeting probably some walleye and pike. That's pretty much, that's mostly in there. So going to be doing that. Got a good lunch packed and it's not too far. I was going to go to Eagle Lake today, but I think everybody in Calgary is going to be fishing there today or somewhere is close by. So I figure, but Crawlin's a pretty big reservoir. You can drive right on the ice. You can jump around and lots of good spots to catch walleye and pike in there. So I figure I'd set that. Also, I'm fixed my auger. I got that bolt on there, so that was good. But I also have an Eskimo Stingray 33cc 8-inch auger. I've had it for years. The fuel line was leaking, so I've got the fuel line finally, and I fixed it last night. I started it up just before I started up the car here, and it started right up. Like no problem. So that's gonna definitely save my the unit that I use. I've got one of those Milwaukee brushless drills, and I use the manual auger piece, but you know, like they're not really meant for chipping through 2 or 3 feet of ice. Your batteries and blades get worn down to hell after couple hours of use. Like I had one battery out there at I think it was Badger I was doing. I did like two holes and it killed one of my the M18 batteries. I got these other batteries off Amazon, the next best ones, as they would call them, like 2 for $80 or whatever. And as soon as the cold, I did have my batteries in the car, but I had it outside for about 20 minutes and the battery just completely like froze on me. So maybe I got to be like the maybe get one of those better name units like Litwin Fishing and Angling Spiders use. Those look like pretty good drills to have, but you know, like I'm kind of a fish on a budget type of Joe. So so that's good that I got that. That auger weighs a ton, but when you can drive on the ice, it's kind of good to have it, right? Because you don't get issues with batteries and stuff like that. Anyways, that's enough of my yakking, and let's get on the road and get our lines in the water. Just got to Crawlin Valley campground here. We're gonna see how busy it is here. Try the boat launch side today. See what luck brings me over here. Yar. It'd be a good day for ice fishing. Mm-hmm. Says me, B-I, says I, B-T. Okay, there's a few guys here. Oh, Jesus. That was a stick on the ground there. Like hearing bumps when I run over something. So, but, holy fuck, does she look busy? There's even one guy blocking the boat launch here. Yes, the question is it looks very, very busy out here. Get back to you guys in a sec here. Back here, and it looks real busy out here today. Especially like on the campground side, like I don't know how far you guys can see, but there's a ton of people down by the weed line there, just off the campground. Angling Spiders, I don't know where you were fishing. Expect you to give up your hide spots there, but that looks like a lot of people are fishing for pike over there. So if that's kind of where, yeah, looks like that guy's got a couple tip ups there. kind of got a spot that I'm heading to that is good. And I know for sure that there will be fish there, so. Still nothing yet, but the bite timer, I don't know how much time I'm going to wait, but there's a bunch of holes around here. I was going to wait till around a little bit after 3 here, and if nothing goes off, got my chili here and my Coleman stove. So I'm going to fire this guy up because it's lunchtime here. This is my homemade chili. So let's get this guy. Get this guy fired up here. There we go. Take this guy. Just let that kind of sit in there for a bit. That's going to cook on that stove and that'll be all ready. And then hopefully... This is kind of a good setup because I can watch my my tip-ups from here. There's a shitload of people down there. I don't know if they're catching anything. Maybe they're in the right spot today. But I know a few more spots I can go for pike because the prime time is between like about 4 and 5 o'clock. So we've got a little ways before then. But right now we're going to wait for the chili to cook here. So, hey, guys. My homemade chili here. It's cooking up pretty good. It was a nice block, but as you can see, she melted out pretty good, so that should be ready in a couple minutes. Looking forward to that. This is my setup here. I got this tip up here which hasn't gone off, and then I got a little tip up for walleye that's kind of over there, and majority of the people I'm seeing are kind of over by the campground, so maybe that's kind of where I was supposed to be going there. But like I said, any day of fishing is better than a day of work, right? So I know one spot I can go for pike. I've actually, well, the years passed, it's been a while since I've been to this spot, but I remember going about 5-6 years ago. Just about every time I went there, I usually caught something. I won't make any promises. Be nice to get something today, but yeah. So hope you guys are catching as much as I am, and we'll see you at the next spot we jump down to. Hey guys, so my bite timer went off, no bites. So we're just kind of moving off this point here. Ice is cracking like crazy, but that's just the top part there. Yeah, I'm not seeing, it's still a nice day out, so we still got a couple hours left before it's quitting time, so we'll try a couple of tip-ups around this area, see what happens, so.